There are two types of transitions. We have video transitions and audio transitions. In this series, we're going to take a closer look at them and how to utilize them to make better videos. And in case we haven't met, my name is Lila, also known as Lila from YouTube, and you're watching Become the Premiere Pro. Let's start with what transitions are. Now, transitions, very simply put, are a way to connect one shot to the other shot. And there are different ways of using transitions. We can use in-camera transition shots as well as built-in transitions in Adobe Premiere Pro and different editing techniques and effects that can be used on video, audio, or both. However, we don't need to use a transition every single time we want to do this. Normally, when we do this, it is to either show the passing of time or to change location. If there's a jump in the storyline, this is a great moment to connect those shots together by using a transition shot. And by using the transitions, we help progress the storyline of our vlog and keep our viewers engaged. Now, the worst thing that you can do as an editor is disengage your audience by interrupting the flow of your video. This is also why a hard cut without a transition can be disorienting in the wrong way. And the key with transitions is to be intentional about when and why you use them, but we'll talk a bit more about that later in this video. There are a lot of different transitions that we can use in our YouTube videos, and we will touch on most of those in this series. But let's start with the most basic transition, which is a basic cut. Yep. Just a literal cut between two shots. I know this is the most uninteresting transition that you want to use in your videos, but it is used so often that it is worth a mention. Now, a more interesting transition cut is the match cut. A match cut is a really fun way to jump from one location to another location in your video. Now, to help match up these frames, you can put one on top of the other in Adobe Premiere Pro and lower the opacity. Then just play around with the scaling and the position to match the frames as accurately as possible. Now, another cut that is not just a transition cut, but just a great cut in general, is the J and L cut. Now, I use these cuts in all of my videos all the time. For transitions, it is a great way to build a bridge between one shot or one scene to the other. Now, for example, if you use a J cut, you're introducing the audio before you show the video. Here's an example. It just makes me happy. The sun makes me happy. The cloudiness does not, but today is a sunny day. This is exactly what I needed today.
It is so nice out.
As you can see, or hear, the J cut creates a bridge between my vlog and the following shot on the beach. It doesn't feel as abrupt as when you would use a hard cut, which would look like this.
But today is a sunny day.
This is exactly what I needed today.
It is so nice out.
An L cut works the opposite way from a J cut, because with an L cut, you keep playing the audio of clip A while you cut to the video of clip B.
The sun makes me happy. The cloudiness does not, but today is a sunny day.
This is exactly what I needed today.
It is so nice out.
In a YouTube video, we can show the passing of time in a few different ways. Now, the simplest way to do this is by using text. We can literally cut between two different locations or two different days using a text layer. Just put that text layer in between those two shots and add the words "the next day." Now, another very popular and fun way to show the passing of time in your YouTube video or in your vlog is by using time lapses. Now, you can either film those yourself if you have the time and then speed them up in Premiere Pro, or you can just grab them from Adobe stock. There's tons of footage available that you can use for your video, so it's definitely something that you can take advantage of. Now, you can just download a preview to see if it fits the storyline and the mood of your video before you license it. I personally have downloaded stock time lapses before because it just saves so much time and it looks good. It's just brilliant. Another way to show the passing of time or changing location is by using music. For example, we can use a funky tune to show that we have gone from location A to location B, or that we have done an action. How we would do this in Premiere Pro is just mark all of the beats of that tune and then use those different clips that show how you complete an action or how you move from one location to another location. Just cut that to the beat, and now you've got yourself a nice transition. But that's not all, because there are still in-camera transitions that we can use, like a whip transition or a dip to black transition, but also lens flares and glitch transitions. In Premiere Pro, there are also a lot of built-in transitions that we can use. So let's get started by clicking on this card right here.